Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The day of Eid, my beloved brothers and sisters. The greeting on the day of Eid is still Assalamu alaykum. Remember, Assalamu alaykum is a greeting of Jannah. It's a greeting of Allah. It's a greeting of Adam alayhi salam. It's a greeting of the angels. It's a greeting of the prophets. It's a greeting of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So remember, never replace it with something. You meet someone, the first thing you do, Assalamu alaykum. You could add to that, wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace be upon you and the blessings of Allah and His mercy. That is the greeting, even on the day of Eid. But after that, you may want to add a cultural greeting. You may want to congratulate someone for something. You may want to say good morning, or whether it's in Arabic or English, sabahul khair, or good morning in English, etc. You may want to say Eid Mubarak to someone, you know, may Allah bless you on this day, etc. All of that can only come secondary, not as a primary Islamic greeting. Just remember that. So, my brothers and sisters, we ask Allah to grant every one of us not just a blessed day of Eid, but a blessed season. The day of Eid, the 10th day of Dhul Hijjah. Amazing day. It's a very intensive day, not just for those in Hajj, but even those out of Hajj. If you can afford it, you should be sacrificing an animal for the sake of Allah, following the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and the sunnah of the Prophet Ibrahim, may peace be upon him. And subhanAllah, one thing that is very, very amazing is that animal. Allah says it's not about the meat, it's not about the blood, it's about the taqwa from it. لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. The meat and the blood is not going to get to Allah. The taqwa will get to Allah. The God consciousness. What are you ready to sacrifice for Allah? Here's Ibrahim alayhi salam, his life, what he sacrificed. What about you? What are you ready to sacrifice? So it's not all about the meat, although Allah wants you to enjoy because you've made promises to Allah and you've changed your life. So Allah wants you to enjoy the meat, and He says, don't enjoy it alone. You must distribute it in a third. So a third for you, a third for family and friends, and a third for the poor. That's how you should be doing things. So alhamdulillah, we thank Allah Almighty for giving us a blessed day of Eid. And that will happen after the Salatul Eid. Salatul Eid, you're supposed to be coming out for Salatul Eid, the prayer of Eid. Everyone should be coming out for the prayer of Eid. Now, we do know this year there are restrictions. Perhaps in some places people may not be able to gather the way they used to, but in some places they will. Either way, remember, you put on something good, you smell good, you bathe, you make sure that you're clean. You're excited, you say your takbir aloud, the declaration and proclamation of the greatness of Allah. You say that aloud and you actually enjoy what Allah has blessed you. You go for Salatul Eid, you have the sacrifice, you meet each other, you congratulate each other, you reach out to the poor and so much more. Don't engage in the displeasure of Allah on the day of Eid. Don't. Because that's a day Allah gave you to enjoy. Allah gave you to enjoy the fact that you've worshipped all these days. Now here's a day of happiness and joy. Joy and happiness is never achieved through sin. Those who think that I'm going to be happy just by releasing myself into my lusts and desires, they don't ever become happy. It's very short term. You want long term true happiness? Engage in the relationship with Allah. Engage in the beautiful connection with Allah. As for those who are in Hajj, what will be happening on the day of Eid? Well, it's the day of Nahr, the day of the great sacrifice. That's what it is. And they will move from Arafah they had moved from Arafah to Muzdalifah the previous night. From Muzdalifah, they're going to move back to Mina. They're going to pelt the shaitan. And then they will sacrifice their animal. And then they will cut their hair or shave their hair, depending. They can choose either one for the males. For the females, they just clip their hair from some places. When that is done, Allah allows you to come out of ihram, come out of the condition that you were in terms of your clothing and all other restrictions, the restrictive condition, everything has been lifted. But you would still need to go for what is known as tawaf, tawaf, circumambulation of the house, tawaf ziyara, before all the restrictions are lifted. Now, in the meantime, this great day of sacrifice is a day filled with amazing worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So remember, that is one of the greatest days. One of the greatest days. After the day of Arafah, we have the day of Nahr, the day after it. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, got up on so many occasions during his pilgrimage to tell the people, to give them words of advice, to warn them about their treatment of one another, how they should be treating women, what they should be doing, how they should be following his sunnah, and so on. All these pieces of advice were amazing. May Allah help us read through the sermons and practice upon them. Inshallah, we have another episode. I look forward to continuing. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.